say, well, what? Did you do that? You do that? You should say, yeah. So I leave you alone. But we ain't leaving you alone.
That's right.
That's right.
Because we gotta wake our people up. What color are the people in the Bible, sir? Many different colors of prophets. What color were they? Were they white? Were they red? Now they watch this. You said white, you said red, yellow. Let's see what the Bible says. Because if I say it clean, then I have to be able to back it up by what the Bible says. Yes? Alright, read. The book of Job, chapter 30, verse 30. So now we're reading about the prophet Job. Read.
My skin?
My what?
My skin!
My what?
My skin!
Show me your skin. Where's your skin? Point to your skin. Point to your skin. Point to your skin. Read.
My skin is black.
Is what?
Is black.
Job said his skin was black. That's in the Bible. So Job was a dark-skinned man like you. We don't know we got the greatest history ever. But because you've been dumbed down by our oppressors, you don't know these things. But the prophet Job was a black man.
That's right.
Give me some of the Solomon. Let's read about the richest king that ever lived. Let's see what color he was. Young man right here. Citizen. Citizen right here. Read what you got. Song of Solomon 1. Hey, Bob.
And the book of Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5. I am black.
So Solomon said that what? He was black. Did you know that, sister? Right here with the blue shirt. Did you know that Solomon was a black man according to the Bible? And why is that important? Because we have to know these things. You understand? Every other nation know who they are. But the nation of Israel, the people on this side right here, they don't know who they are. You got Isaiah 1 and 3. We as the people don't know who we are. We got to find out, why did God make us? You understand what I'm saying? We got to begin to wonder, why are we in the lowest condition no matter where you live? Back in the States, the people that look like us is in the worst condition. That too. Don't be fooled by television. It's not like that. You understand what I'm saying? So we have to begin to wonder these things. Read.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 3. The ox knoweth his owner.
God says the ox, which is a dumb animal, he knows his owner. He knows where his power is. He knows what he's supposed to be. Read. His homeland. Read.
And he asked his master his crib.
Read.
But Israel.
But God says Israel, the Israelites. The people in the sign. Which tribe y'all come from? Y'all, you wouldn't be considered Belizean. You would be considered Belizean? Okay. So what does that mean? That means y'all come from the tribe of Zebulun. Where we at? I'm looking at the upside of that. Y'all already know we from the tribe of Zebulun. Me? I'm from the tribe of Levi. He's from the tribe of Judah. What we're sharing, brother. What we're sharing, sister. This brother right here, The people of the Bible were all black men.
That's right.
Did you know that? Did you know that? You didn't know that? Read it again. Go back to Song of Solomon.
Look up Song of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5. I am black.
I am what?
I am black.
So this is Solomon speaking. Did you hear that? He says, I am black. What color is your skin? We would say, we are black people, right? Solomon said the same thing. I am black. Read.
But comely.
But comely. But comely. But comely. Comely means handsome. Why does he have to say that? Because society teaches what? The people with dark skin are ugly. Ain't that how they have it on TV? The people with light skin, they always put it on TV. The models with light skin, they always in videos, right? But Solomon said, I am comely, but I'm black. All of the prophets were black men. Now, watch this. Jeremiah 17 and 4. Because you make the point. All of the people in the Bible were black. But what else is it for us to know as a people? Jeremiah 17 and 4.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 4. And thou, even thyself.
So God says, this is what God says. God says, we. Read.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue.
Shall what?
Shalt discontinue.
So God said, we as a people will discontinue from our heritage. Have you been discontinued from the heritage? Have you been discontinued from your heritage, sis? What about you right here with the blue vest? have you been discontinued from your heritage? Yes? What would you say?
Right here.
Okay, I would now say yes. And I'm gonna prove that. You celebrate Christmas? Do you celebrate Christmas? Do you celebrate Christmas? Do you celebrate Christmas? Yeah, I bet you do, right? But I bet none of y'all knew because you discontinued from your heritage or what? Christmas is of the devil.
Sick.
In the Bible, God says not to celebrate Christmas. You believe that? Give me Jeremiah 10. You believe that? Christmas is not of God.
Sick.
Christ, Jesus Christ, was not born in December. He was not born in December 25th. He was not born in the winter at all. But because we don't know who we are as a people, we don't know these things. Because we've been discontinued from our heritage. We think we're Belizean. We think we're American, Guatemalan. You understand what I'm saying? Listen to what the Bible says.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel.
So who is God speaking to? The house of Israel, right? It says, hear the word that God is speaking unto you, O house of Israel. The whole Bible is about the Israelites.
Right?
Read it again.
Hear ye the word which the Lord is speaking unto you, O house of Israel.
So God is speaking to the Israelites. This is where God says, listen up. Because it's something that you've been doing wrong that you're not supposed to do. Read.
Thus saith the Lord.
Thus saith God. So this is a commandment. Read.
Learn not the way of the heathen.
God says not to learn the way of the heathen. The other nation. Because God gave us holy days to celebrate. The Sabbath. Feast of dedication. Pentecost. God gave us days to celebrate. You understand? Read it.
Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
God says, don't be amazed by the stars that's in the heavens, the stars that's in the sky. Y'all understand that? I'm gonna bring it full circle in a second. Read.
For the heathen are dismayed at them.
Read.
For the custom of the people are vain.
God says, the customs of the people are vain. What? They don't benefit us any. Christmas does not benefit us.
Read. For one planted a tree out of the forest.
So now God is telling us what are the customs of the people. He says a man goes into the forest and cuts down a tree. Read that part again.
For one planted a tree out of the forest.
God says a man goes into the forest and cuts down a tree. Do we cut down trees for Christmas? We don't. Where does everybody get the Christmas tree from there? Where? We now we buy it, but in times past, they got it for it. Now we use plastic trees. Why? Because we poor. But in times past, they went into the forest and cut it down. Back in the States, they used real trees. You understand what I'm saying? So God says, what are the customs here that the people go into the forest and cut down a tree? Free.
The work of the hands of the workmen with the axe.
He cuts down the tree with the axe.
Free. They deck it with silver and gold.
And then they deck it with silver and gold. They decorate it with silver and gold. Is that how they celebrate Christmas? They don't celebrate Christmas like that? Here, how do you celebrate Christmas? Because we've been here a few days, and guess what? When we see the Christmas tree, they're decorated. They have the ornaments on them, yes? That's what God is saying. They decorate it with silver ornaments and with gold ornaments. Read it again.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
That's the ornaments. You understand what I'm saying? So yes, Christmas is the Bible. God says not to do this. Read.
They fasten it with nails and with hammers. That it move not.
You see people up on Christmas tree and they put it on the sand so they don't fall over. That's just what God is saying. We don't know Christmas is an old pagan custom. Did you know that, sis? Christmas is an old custom. Read that part again.
They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and with hammers. That it moves not.
And it moves not. Now watch this. You remember when God said not to be dismayed at the stars in heaven? what do they put on top of the Christmas tree? A what? A what? A star, right? Why? Because you're worshiping that star when you put it on the Christmas tree. So God says not to be amazed by that. That's how you know this is talking about Christmas. Read verse 1 again. The part about the stars. Read it again.
Verse 1. Hear ye the word of the Lord, which spake unto you, house of Israel.
One second. My sister's right here. My sister's right here. Do y'all celebrate Christmas? Do you celebrate Christmas here? Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question. Read it right again.
Hear ye the word which the Lord spake unto you, house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, Lord, not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
So that's what God says about Christmas. Don't be dismayed at the stars, the signs of heaven. Now, I want to ask you a question. She's about to close. I want to deal with her too.
Hi, this is Sister Kyle.
So, hey, how you doing? Okay, come closer so I can hear you. Please, come closer so I can hear you. We're discussing the Bible. I was just discussing with my brother. What's your name? Huh? I can't hear you, bro.
Carlos.
I was just talking to Carlos about Christmas. Do you celebrate Christmas? Did you know that Christmas is the Bible that's not to celebrate? Did you know that? You know that? Okay, so you celebrate Christmas, but you said you understand that God says not to celebrate Christmas. It's not a tradition. Why do you celebrate Christmas? Jesus wasn't born on December 25th. Did you know that? Come close to me. Just come a little close. Step right here. Step right here. I'm going to show you because some people may consider it to be embarrassing to not know. But that's okay. That's why we're here. So that we can show all people what's good and we can show all people what's wrong about what they do. God says a man is supposed to wear a beard. God says a woman is supposed to wear dresses. We have to eat Sabbath. We can't eat pork. We can't eat shrimp, lobster. All of these are commandments we're supposed to keep. Now my sister said that Jesus Christ was born on December 25th. Yeah. But that's not what the Bible says. Give me Luke chapter 2. You got it? You know what I want? Give me Luke chapter 2. My sister right here with the blue shirt. Can I ask you a question? Can I ask you a question? Do you celebrate Christmas?
No.
You don't? Why not?
Because I don't believe that Jesus Christ was born on December 25th.
I can't hear you. Can you come closer, please? Please.
I don't
hear that good. Come closer.
I don't believe that Jesus Christ was born on December 25th.
Okay. Very well. Very well. Very well. Okay. So let me ask you this.
I believe on all of the faith that you have mentioned that we should not be eating.
Okay.
If we are interested in our body and our health, we need to read the biblical chapter 11 and teach us all of our
things. So the question is, what you say is beautiful. I'm going to ask you a question after I read the scripture. Give me 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Let's see what God says about it, right? Because I can say something and I just be speaking in my own heart. But I can just write in my own mind, right? But we have to lean on God's word. Read.
Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16. Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
God says that we are his temple. You understand? Read.
And is that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you?
And God's Spirit is trying to dwell within us. But when we are in the midst of sin, that can happen. Right? So when we eat shrimp, crab, lobster, God's Spirit can dwell within us. When we smoke, God's Spirit can dwell in us because we defile our temple. When we celebrate Christmas, God's Spirit can dwell within us. You understand? Here's another thing. When men or women wear the thing they aren't supposed to wear, God's Spirit can dwell within us. Right? So my question to you is, because you already said, you believe what we said about the nine people in the Bible. You believe what we said about Christmas, about unloaded food. How is it, or would you consider yourself to be a godly woman?
Of course, yeah.
Okay. So the answer is, how is a godly woman supposed to dress?
Modest.
Well, what does modest mean?
Covering our body.
Okay.
Covering our body, looking for spiritual, because that's the words of God said that people should be able to identify.
Jesus Christ.
Alright, so hold it. Don't go anywhere.
Which one is Jesus?
Do you know what color Jesus Christ is?
That one right there.
So what color Jesus Christ is? Do you know? Jesus Christ was talking to you.
That's right.
Watch this.
But it's good to know.
Can I share it with you? Can I share it with y'all? Which one of these would y'all consider to be Jesus? It's okay. This one? This one? Okay, now I'll say this. Very good, very good. This is what the Bible says Jesus Christ looked like. Revelation chapter 1, verse 14. His head and his hair were white like wool. So it says Jesus Christ, his head, right? And his hair, meaning his beard, was what? White like wool. It was white, but it was like wool. Meaning Jesus Christ had hair like you, young man.
That's
woolly hair. Hair like me, hair like him. Woolly hair. You understand? Read it again. Jesus Christ had hair like you. Hair like you. When you take the braids out, ain't your hair woolly? Yeah, right? You gotta be proud of it, but that's how God looks.
That's right.
Read it again. His head and his hair were white like wool. So Jesus Christ had white woolly hair. What's funny about that? It's funny that, why don't we laugh when people say Jesus Christ looks like this? Why do we laugh when we say Christ looks like that? We have to be proud in how we look.
That's right, hallelujah.
We have to
be proud in how we look.
That's right.
God made us beautiful.
Hallelujah.
God made us handsome.
Hallelujah.
We are the salt of the earth.
That's right.
Don't all the other nations want to be like us? Don't all the models want the full lips like we got? They want their eyes like our eyes? They want to be strong and built like our men? That's because God made us perfect. God made us beautiful. We gotta rejoice in that.
That's right.
We gotta be happy in that. Because your Lord is saying it looks like you. Read it again.
His head and his hair were white as wool, as white as snow.
And Jesus Christ had white hair, white as snow, like your grandpa. Y'all understand? Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Say his eyes were like a flame of fire. Because Jesus Christ running blind. Read.
And his feet is what?
What color are your feet? Sisters right here, brother right here. Come here. Young man, come here. Step up. It's okay. What color are your feet? Brown. Your feet is brown, right? And the color of your feet matches the rest of your body, right? So, by understanding what part of Jesus Christ's feet was, we know how he looked. Read it again.
At his feet, like on the fine grass.
So it said, Jesus Christ's feet look like fine grass. What color is grass? Brown!
Good.
So Jesus Christ's skin was brown. But let's see how brown. Read.
His head and his hair were white and
but the texture was like wool. Feel your hair. Feel your hair. That's how Christ's hair was.
Hey.
Jesus Christ was a black man.
Read. As white as snow.
And it said his hair was white as snow. Read.
And his eyes were the flame of fire.
Read.
And his feet.
Now it's talking about his feet. Look down at your own feet. This is John the Apostle talking about how Christ looked. Because he walked with Christ. So he knew how Christ looked. You understand? So he looked down at Jesus Christ's feet. And what did he say?
At his feet, like on the fine grass.
He said, Jesus Christ's feet, the color of it was like fine grass. What color is grass? What color? Grass.
He said, it depends.
Come here, tell me what you mean by that. What color is grass? Brown. So John looked at Jesus Christ's feet and said his feet was the color of grass. Meaning brown. Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
But his feet was brown and it looked like they had been burned in a furnace. When you burn something, what color does it turn? Black. So Jesus Christ was very dark skinned. You understand? So we have to be proud in how we look.
Right.
Because our Savior looks the same way. We have to be proud of our holy hair. If our hair is less holy like my brother here, we still have to be proud.
Right.
Why? Because God came back to save the Israelites. The Bible is not for everybody, it's for the Israelites. You will consider yourself pleasing, yes? Yes? Everybody here will consider themselves pleasing. But according to the Bible, the people of Belize are from the tribe of Zebulon. Jesus Christ didn't come back to save everybody. Only the 12 tribes of Israel. Give me 1 Corinthians 11. Let me show you something. I'm going to show you why it's not good for you to come to the head. How do you understand? Come closer, please. Come closer. But if you were just talking about Jesus Christ, did you hear how it said Jesus Christ looked? What? Yeah!
That's right.
That don't make you happy? That should make you happy, right? Watch this. Give me in here, microphone. This is Psalm 13.
Verse 3, with whose beauty, if they be delighted, took them to be gods. Let them know how much better the world of them is.
So this is what it says. God created all of us, yes? All of you here. From the very beginning, Adam was the so-called white man. He looked like us, Adam.
Right.
Did you know that? You know that, did you? That sounds strange. One second, hold you. Give me Genesis 2 and 7. I'll hold this. Give me Genesis 2 and 7. Listen to how it said Adam, the very first man, looked. And now today, the Israelites are all shades of brown. That's what the Bible says. Because our parents, we have to look like our parents, right? Some of our parents are a little lighter. Some of our parents are a little darker. So what? You have all the variations in between that. But nevertheless, we all are of the 12 tribes of Israel. Read what you got.
The book of Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground.
The Bible says Adam was formed of the dust of the ground. What color is dust? Dirt. Brown, black, right? Dark. So Adam, the very first man, was a black man according to the Bible. We have to be proud of that. Never read that. Verse 3, read it again.
The book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 13, verse 3. With whose beauty, if they be delighted, took them to be gods. Let them know how much better.
The Bible says, let them, let the Israelites know how much better. We better than all the other nations.
That's right.
If you consider yourself believing, you are better than the other nations.
That's right.
You are better than an East Indian man. You are better than a Chinese man.
What?
The Japanese man.
Verse 3, we lose beauty, if they be delighted, took them to be gods. Let them know how much better.
How much what?
How much better. The Lord of death, where the first
God made us in his image. You understand? But there's a problem with that. It's good to know all of the people in the Bible was black. That's good. People of color, right? Because not all of the prophets were your complexion. Some was his complexion. Some was her complexion. But we all are the same people.
Same blood.
Same blood. Yes. Yes. We all have the same blood. But the problem is, the people where I'm from.
What is a nation? Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is men leading by example. Nation is women's support. Nation is children with role models. Nation is unity. Nation is